Hey, what's up, and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. My name is Kaylee. I got the okay to start teaching again. I know that my last video, I said I didn't know when I would be back filming for YouTube, but I feel so much better in terms of my injury and my body, and it honestly feels better to move. So we're going to do a low impact Pilates class today. It will be 45 minutes, full body, and low impact does not mean that it isn't challenging. It's going to be a spicy one as usual. If you want to up level, you can grab a booty band and ankle weights and heavier weights if that feels like something that you want to do. But the props that I'm going to work with today are just a Pilates ball and a light set of weights, so I have 3 pounds. Again, grab whatever feels good in your body, and let's get started. We'll start in a tabletop shape, stacking wrists under shoulders, knees under hips, finding a neutral spine to start. So slight tuck of the tailbone, pull your belly button back towards your spine, reach the crown of the head forward, your neck is long, and then on your inhale, cow pose, belly drops, gaze lifts. Exhale, tuck round, push into the hands, arch the upper back. Couple more like that, inhale. And exhale. So in these first few movements, just checking out how your body feels. Noticing where the mind is at. And can you keep bringing yourself back to the present moment? So really feeling your body, every sensation that's going on. And coming back to your breath whenever you feel distracted. Beautiful, come to a neutral table. Let's slide the right leg back, lifting it up to the sky, and then step it forward outside of the right hand. Tuck the back toes, lift the back knee. You can come onto your fingertips here if that feels good. We're just gonna take a couple circles. So starting to warm up the hips, inner thigh, and then switch the direction of those circles. You can always have the left knee down here if that feels better. Again, I want this to be practice that's for you. So you can always modify, you can always level up, you can always adjust. Beautiful, meeting here, plant the left hand, inhale, right arm to the sky, find a twist. On your exhale, tap your right hand to your left knee underneath you. Again, inhale, lift it up. Exhale, tap. Last one, big breath in. And big breath out. Inhale to find that twist. And then exhale, right hand down, left knee down. Push the hips back, straighten the leg, diagonal half splits. Flex the right toes. Think about reaching the crown of the head forward, feeling an opening in the back of the right leg. Beautiful, gently releasing, plant the right foot. Plant the hands, you can walk the left knee in and then slide the right knee to a tabletop. Left leg goes back. Step it outside of the hand. Tuck your back toes, lift your right knee, and then take those circles. So finding some movement in the left hip. And then switching the direction of those circles. Beautiful. We'll meet with the left knee bent, plant the right hand. Right knee stays lifted. Inhale, left arm to sky, big twist. On your exhale, thread left hand down to touch your right knee. Inhale, lift it up. Exhale, thread. One more, inhale. And exhale. Beautiful, find your twist, big breath in. Big breath out, left hand down, right knee down, push the hips back. Half splits, left leg is still at the diagonal, so pointing away from the midline. Flex the left toes, reach the crown of the head forward. Take a big breath in here. And a big breath out. Beautiful, plant the left foot, plant the hands, tabletop. Grab one lightweight. We're gonna put the light weight in the right hand, left hand will plant. Tuck your toes under, find your plank or stay on your knees, whatever feels better for you. We're gonna open up to a side plank. In 3, two, one, right here. Open for two, close to your plank. Open, open, close, close. All right, so you're spinning the hips open. Your feet are staggered, not stacked. So you have a wider center of gravity. You're moving your right arm up with that weight. Eight more, eight. So good. Six, we're gonna keep it open in that side plank. In four, three, two, one. Next time, keep it open, pulse the hips. Lift, lift, woo. Squeeze, left obliques. Eight more, eight, seven, six, five, four more, four. Then we're gonna take the right hand, try to tap it to the left calf. Right here, thread, tap, lift, side plank. Thread, tap, lift, side plank. So it's like you're piking the hips up to tap that weight to your left shin, left calf. Four more, four, breathe. Three, we're just gonna switch sides. We'll reset in a tabletop in two, in one, right here, knees down. Switch the weight to your left hand. Same thing, open, open, close to your plank. Open, open, close. So now you're moving from the left arm, lift, lift, close, close. Right obliques should be kicking on. Soft bend in your right elbow. You can always come down to your forearm. Here's four, we'll keep it up. Find a little pulse. In three, in two, one right here. Pulse, pulse. So again, your feet are staggered. Left foot is in front of the right. I like to put my whole foot down, my left foot, and really ground into it. All right. Four more, we tap. Four, three, left hand will go to the right shin, right calf. In two, one right here. Tap the shin, lift, side plank. Tap, tap, lift, lift. Tap, tap, lift, lift. We're close, tap. Tap, lift, lift. Four more, four, breathe. Three, two, one. Come on down. Beautiful work. Keep your weight. We're gonna put it into the right hand. Left leg will go back. We're in a tabletop shape. Soft bend in the left elbow. Right weight forward. Let's lift, lift. Arm and leg, lower, lower. Up, up, down, down, lift. And lower, all right. Engage your core, down, down. Lift, and lower. Option, no weight here. It will be spicy for the shoulders even without it. If you do have that weight, your palm faces the midline so that you have a neutral position in the shoulder. Lift, and lower. So good, down and up, lower and lift. Eight more, six, then we'll keep it lifted. We'll find a little pulse. You've got it. In four, three, two, one, right here, lift. Lift, woo, lift, lift. Four more, four. Then we're gonna curl elbow to knee underneath us. Push it out long. In two, one right here. In, out. So now you're pulling the knee in to the elbow. Your thumb is still facing up, your palm faces the midline. Eight more, eight, seven, six, five, four more, four, three, two, one, keep it in, open, open, close. So now your right elbow is bent, your left knee is bent, you're opening away from the midline, then closing back in. Open, close, yes. Eight more, eight, seven, six, five, four more, four. We keep it open, little pulse. In three, in two, one right here, lift, lift. We're almost done with this side. Lift, lift. Keep breathing, lift, lift. All right, four more, four, three, two, and one, reset. Grab that weight in the left hand, right toes go back, soften in your right elbow. We'll lift right here, lift and lower, lift and lower, so good. Lift and lower, soft bend in your joints, both arms down and lift. You're squeezing your right glute, lift and lower, lift and lower. Eight more, eight, seven, six, and we keep it lifted, little pulse. In four, in three, in two, in one, right here, keep it lifted, pulse, pulse. Soft bend in your elbow, pulse, lift, woo. All right, we're gonna pull elbow to knee. In two, one right here, in, long, use your core, in, out, keep breathing, in, out, yes. Four more, four. Then we're gonna keep it in, open and close. In two, one right here, keep it in, open, close. Like that fire hydrant shape. Nice. Close, open. Close, open. So close. Close, open. Close, open. Let's find that pulse. In four, three, two, one. Little lifts. This is your last push. Little lift, lift. Little higher, little smaller, you've got this. Lift, lift. Four more. Four, three, two, one. Lower all the way down. Woo, awesome job. I am definitely feeling warm. All right, put that weight down. Come to a seat, grab your ball. Let's warm up the core even more. Lay all the way down. Grab the ball. Place it in the center of your thighs. Push both hands into it. This is where a foam roller could work really well. We're gonna lift the chest as we slide the ball up towards the knees. Move slow. In two, one. Lift, lift, lower, lower. So really pushing into that ball. You should feel that engage your chest and deep layers of your core. Lift and lower, speed it up. Lift, lower. All right, head is heavy. Your chin away from your chest. And you're pushing your neck back just a little bit so that it's still in line with your spine. That will kick on your neck muscles so that they're working instead of just picking up the tension. Lift, lower. You can always just do a regular crunch if this doesn't work for your neck. Lift, lower. We're gonna keep it lifted. Little press on that ball right here. Push, push. So you're pushing the ball into your knees. Push, or into the tops of your thighs rather. My arms are shaking. Push. Chin away from the chest. You can lay your head back if you need to. Push. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Four more. Four. We're gonna do that again. This time we'll roll up to a full boat pose. You've got it. Into one right here. Lower to start. We're gonna lift, roll the ball, and lower, lower, lift, lift, lower, lower, lift, lift, lower, lower. Keep breathing. Down and up. Use your core. Lower, woo, and lift. Try not to crash down like I did that last time. Down and up. Keep it up. Straighten the legs. Roll the ball to your toes. Roll it back to your belly. Roll it up. Roll it down. Keep going. Roll it up. Roll it down. Get a little taller. Roll it up. Roll it down. Four more. Four. Three, two, one. Beautiful. All right. Come to a seat for a moment. Keep your ball. We're going to transition onto our side. Let's start on our left side. Ball is going to be underneath left ribs. I'm going body weight on this one. This could be a great place for ankle weights. So underneath left rib, left forearm is down. Left knee is bent, right leg is long. Take your right hand to your hip, stack your hips. So roll your right hip forward slightly, engage your core. We're gonna pull the right knee into the chest, kick it forward, swing it back in line with the hip, pull it back into the chest. Forward, swing back, knee in, forward, swing back, knee in. So moving slow, it's like a slow bicycle. Or like you're swimming, in, kick, back, in, forward. Try to make this graceful, like you're moving through water or honey, something that you have to move a little bit slower through, a little bit more controlled. Think about keeping your torso and your upper body really still here, so only moving from that leg. Yes. Forward and back. Eight more. Eight. Keep breathing. Seven. My leg is getting heavy. Six. Five. Four more. You've got it. Four. Woo. Three. Then we're going to keep it forward. Tap and lift. In two. In one, right here, point the toes, tap, lift. Woo! Stack your hips. Right hip on top of left. You should really feel this in your booty. Lift, lower. So good. Lift, lower. Chest is broad. You're pushing into your left elbow. Here's eight, seven, six, five, four more, four. Then we're gonna reverse that bicycle. We'll start by pulling the knee into the chest, then taking it long. In two, in one. Keep it lifted, pull the knee in, kick it long in line, swing the leg forward, knee back in. Back, swing, knee in, back, swing, knee in, back, swing, knee in. Woo! So this way always feels a little bit more awkward for my body. But just focus on moving really slow and controlled, feeling every muscle work in your right leg. Forward, in, back. Yes. So good. Let's do four more, then we'll keep it back, lower and lift. In two. In one, right here, lower, lift. So now your leg is in line with your hip. Lift, lower. If you can already tell, we're working side booty. Lift, lower. Four more, four. Then we're just gonna switch sides. In three, in two, one right here. Push up onto a seat. Ball goes underneath the right ribs now. Right forearm is down, left knee is bent, left leg is long. Readjust, stack your hips, left on top of right. Point your left toes. Beautiful, we're gonna pull the knee in, kick it forward, swing it back. In, forward, back. All right, maybe this side feels different. No, it does in my body. So readjust as you need to. You're pulling the knee in, kicking it forward, then swinging it back. Yes, really slow and controlled. Keep your upper body really still. Keep breathing. In, forward, and back. Forward, back, in. So good. My legs are burning. Still feel my right one. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Then we're gonna keep it forward. We'll tap and lift. In four, three, two, one, right here. Tap, lift, tap, lift. Woo! Tap, lift. All right, let's reverse that direction. In four, three, two, one. Knee in, kick it in line with your hip. Swing forward, knee in. Out, forward, in, back. So good. We're close. Stay with me. My leg's on fire. Forward, in, back. Yes. All right. One more set of those tap and lift. We'll keep the leg in line with the hip this time. Tap, lift, tap, lift. Oh my God, I am shaking. Tap, lift, get a little taller. I just noticed I was sagging in my right shoulder. Four more, we're done. Four, three, two, last one. And lower the leg, oh my goodness. Wow, definitely feeling that. All right, let's stay on our right side. Grab a weight if you want one. We're gonna do inner thighs. Lay all the way down, put the ball underneath the left knee. Right hand captures the head. Left, or right leg rather, is long, in line with your hip. Flex your toes and your heel away from the body. Push into your left knee. Let's lift the right leg. Lift, lower, lift, lower. All right, so focusing on getting a lift from the right leg. Up, down, lift, lower. Your core is engaged. You're on your right side line. Lift, lower. Flexing your toes will keep the leg active. Lift, lower. Think about getting your whole right thigh off the mat. Yeah. Down, up. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Six, five, four more, four. Then we're gonna keep it lifted. Little pulse at the top. In three, in two, in one, right here. Little lift up, lift up, lift up, lift up, yes, lift. Little higher, little smaller, you've got this. Eight more, eight, seven, woo, six, five, four more, four. Then we're gonna keep the leg lifted. We'll find a mini bend extend. In two, in one, right here, a little bend extend, bend extend. So you're just slightly taking your right foot and right shin back. Little bend extend, woo. So feeling that in my right inner thigh. Our inner thighs are really important for stabilizing our knees and our hips. Eight more. Eight. And six. We're gonna put the weight down, grab the ball, place it in between the feet. In two, one, lower the leg, little break. Move your weight, grab. Ball in between the feet, bend the knees, left hand in front of you. We're gonna kick the legs long, pull the knees back in. Long, pull, all right. Feeling your left oblique here. In, out. You're still working inner thighs by squeezing that ball. I know it's hard. In, out. Here's eight. Here's six. We're gonna keep it long. Little squeeze on the ball with the feet. In two, in one right here. Little squeeze, squeeze. In, and keep your legs lifted. Squeeze, squeeze. Holy right inner thigh. Here's eight. Here's six. Here's four. Three, two, one. Hold it up and then lower down. Oh my goodness, that was killer. Let's switch sides. Press up, grab your weight on the way. Oops, don't lose your ball. Lay on your left side. Right knee onto your ball. Left leg long, weight in the right hand on your left inner thigh. Let's lift up and down. Lower, lift. Woo! Right leg is still feeling it. Lower, lift. Down, up. You might need to readjust with this side. Mine feels different, so I'm readjusting. Down, up. You're just gently pressing your right knee into your ball. Down, up. It's like a little bit of stability, and you're stabilizing with that inner thigh. Down, up. Flex your left toes, lift, lower. Yes. Here's eight, seven. Try to lift all the way up. Six, five, four more, four. Three, we'll keep it lifted. Little pulse up, you've got it. In two, in one right here. Little lift up, lift up, lift up, lift up. Push your right knee down into that ball. Get your left leg a little bit higher. Yes, lift, lift. This is where I always start to feel it. Lift, lift. Give me eight more, you got it. Eight. Seven, six, five, four more. Four, we'll do that bend extend. Three, in two, in one. Right here, keep it lifted. Bend extend, woo. Little press, so good. Push. Push, all right. We're gonna go to that last sequence. Ball between the feet. In two, in one right here. Reset, weight down. Grab that ball, place it in between your feet. Right hand down, planted strong. Knees in, take it long. Knees in, take it long. You're squeezing that ball. You're trying to keep your left leg off the ground this whole time. Out, in, squeeze. Yes. Feeling your right obliques working. Out, in, woo. All right, let's keep it long. Squeeze that ball. In two, in one, right here. Squeeze in, squeeze in, squeeze in, squeeze in. Oh my goodness. Push into your right hand to lift your legs. Eight more, eight, and six. Here's four, three, two, one. Lower down, awesome job. All right, slide that ball out of the way. Keep one weight or you can grab a heavy weight here as well. We're gonna lay on our back. Step the feet down. Weight is in your right hand to start. Left leg's gonna go up to the sky. Left hand down by your side. We're going to push the weight up as we push the left leg up in 3, 2, 1, right here. Lift, lift to a bridge, lower, lower, lift, lift, lower, lower, yes. Lift, lift, lower, lower, up, and down. So good. Lift and lower. All right. We're going to keep it lifted. We'll reach the weight overhead and the leg long. In 4. We'll keep this slow tempo. In 3. In 2. In 1. Right here. Out for 2. Lift to the sky. Lower. Lower, lift, lift. I like to point my left toes here, but whatever makes you feel good, you can flex them as long as the leg stays active. The hips are staying up the whole time here, so your right glute max is in the work. Lift and lower, yes. Here's 8. Keep breathing. Here's 6. We're gonna hold it low at that hover, little pulse. In 2, in 1, little pulse up, pulse up. Push down into your left hand and right foot. Lift, lift. Woo! That is killer. Lift, lift, up, up. 8 more, you've got it. 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to midline, little pulse, lift. Oh my goodness. 4 more, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch sides, left foot down, weight in your left hand, right hand down, right leg up. Slow lift as you press. In 3, 2, 1, right here. Lift, up, lower, lower. Lift, lift, lower, lower. All right, now you're pushing into your left foot to lift your hips. You're squeezing your left glute. Your right leg is super active, super strong. Lift, lift. So good. Lift and lower. All right, we're gonna keep it up. Extend in 4. We'll keep this slow tempo. In 3, in 2, in 1, right here. Lower for 2, lift for 2. Lower for 2, lift for 2. Lower, lower, lift, lift, lower, lower, lift, lift. Really squeeze down and up. All right, we're gonna keep it low in that hover, little pulse. This time, keep it low, little pulse up. Your hips are lifted. You're really pushing into that left foot. Soft bend in the left elbow, little lift. Little lift. Here's 4. We're gonna take it back up. Last little pulse. In 3, 2, 1. Right here, little push. Up, up, lift, lift. 4 more. 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower all the way down. Woo! Awesome job. All right, slide your weight off to the side. We'll finish out with a little bit of core. Lay all the way down. Head is heavy. We're gonna pull the knees into the chest. Interlace your fingers around your right shin. Take your left leg long. Lift your head and shoulders, engage your core. Option to lay the head back. And then pull left knee in, switching the arms. Right knee, left knee. In, in. You could also take your ball, place it behind your head for a little bit more support. In, in. All right, so we're getting a little stretch here. Should feel good. I'm gonna lay my head back for a little bit. In, in. You'll still get work in the core even if your shoulders are down. Pull your belly button to your spine. Yes. In, in. Pull, pull. All right, we're gonna keep right knee into the chest. In four, three, we'll rainbow the left leg. In two, in one, right here, right knee in. Tap the left toes over to the left, tap them over to the right, left. It's more like the heel, and right. So feeling your left side transverse, working a lot here. Tap left, tap right. Yes, here's eight. Keep your upper body really still. Here's six. Four more, back to that side to side. In four, three, two, one. Right here, left knee, right knee. In, in. Core is engaged. Belly to spine. Pull, pull. Beautiful. All right, let's keep the right leg long. Rainbow. In four, three, two, one. Right here, right leg long. Tap right, tap center. Right, center. Out, in, try to lift your shoulders a little bit more. Tap, 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 eight more, eight, six, four, three, two, one. Pull the knees in and lower the head, awesome job. Step the feet down, let the knees fall in towards each other, close the eyes. Let the arms fall down by the sides. Maybe they rest on the belly. Take a moment to just take a deep breath in. And a deep exhale. Two more like that, big breath in. Big sigh. Last one, inhale. And exhale. Beautiful. You can keep the eyes closed. Heel toe the feet, hips width, and then a couple times windshield wiper the leg side to side. Feels so good. Little massage for the glutes. Starting to bring movement into the spine, the transverse plane. Maybe adding the chin in the opposite direction of the knees. One more. Next time your knees come to the left, keep them there. You can stack right knee on top. You can make it deeper by curling the leg underneath. Gaze towards the right. You can keep your eyes closed. Deep breath in. And deep breath out. Beautiful, switching sides. Legs to the right. Gaze to the left. Couple deep breaths here. Notice if you're holding tension in the face, the shoulders, the jaw. Can you allow it to release? Beautiful, coming back through center, drawing the knees into the chest. Give yourself a big squeeze. can make little circles in your sacrum if that feels good. And then when you're ready, press up to a seat, however you get there. Coming to a comfortable seat, just sitting cross-legged for now. Sitting up nice and tall, you can support yourself with a pillow or a block if you have one and like that. Right hand is gonna go down by the right side, left arm by the ear, big side body stretch. Opening the chest, sliding the left shoulder back, and then switch sides. Left arm down, right arm by the ear, big side body stretch. Couple more. You can move as fast or as slow as feels good. I'm liking the hold today, but you can flow side to side. Feels so good. Couple more. Let's do one more each side. Beautiful, and then coming back through center, reach the arms up to the sky, and then take them all the way down and around. Couple big circles, rolling the shoulders back. Beautiful. Next time your arms are out to a T, keep them there, and then take the right arm across the body, capture it with the left elbow, maybe taking left ear to left shoulder. And then switch sides. Left arm across the body, right ear, right shoulder. Beautiful, opening up the arms, planting the hands down, coming up to stand on the knees. We'll take a little camel flow. Tuck the tailbone under, engage the core, squeeze the glutes. Hands are at your low back to start. And then on your next inhale, start to just lift the spine. So going vertical to start. And then on your exhale, gently leaning back as much as feels good in your body. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Opening up the front side, strengthening the back side. And then when you're ready, come back through neutral. Slightly tuck the tailbone, lengthen the low back. And then come back to neutral spine. We'll do it one more time. You can take your hands to your heels if that feels good. Gently lifting up and then leaning back. Beautiful, coming back up through center, planting the hands down, walking your feet forward. And then taking them all the way out in front of you, lifting up through the crown of the head, pull the knees together, and then start to walk your hands down your legs. My spine feels really tight right now, especially after my injury, so I'm being very gentle today. You can go into a deeper forward fold if that feels good in your body. Think about the tilt in the pelvis, so taking the tailbone up to the sky, that will lengthen the hamstrings as well as protect your low back in this stretch. Think about always leading with a long spine. Maybe deepening as you open. Beautiful. Coming back up, we'll just take the feet together, knees wide for a Baddha Konasana. I'm liking putting my hands behind me for this one recently, but you can grab your toes if that feels good. Press the soles of the feet together and then think about drawing the knees towards the floor. Doesn't matter how far away they are. What matters is feeling a good stretch in the inner thighs. Mine already feel tight after that inner thigh sequence. Think about lifting the chest, lifting the heart. We'll take one more breath here. Beautiful. And then when you're ready to come out, just come to a seat and you are done. Awesome work today. I hope you loved this class. Please let me know if you did. Make sure to subscribe, like this video, and let me know what you'd like to see next. I will see you in my next video. Bye.